Today on Sports Central, we go over our next team projection of this offseason, and it's going to be over the Oklahoma State Cowboys, a team that went 8-3 overall in the 2020 season. Not a bad season at all for Oklahoma State, as this team was a big contender for the majority of the 2020 season. How will this team be in 2021 is what we're going over here today. We're also going to go over a few players that this team will be losing, who they're going to be returning, and also looking at their schedule for the first time this offseason, starting out with the previous six games for Oklahoma State. And this team down the stretch, really, I mean, they played pretty well over the course of last season. They were a pretty consistent team, but of course, down the stretch, they did take a couple of losses, which really ruined their chances of making a run at the College Football Playoff or the Big 12 Championship. But this team did beat Kansas State 20-18. They lost to Oklahoma 13-41. That was a pretty terrible loss for Oklahoma State there. If they could have won that game, this team could have easily been a big contender, I think, for the College Football Playoff even. This team had a ton of potential going into that matchup. But they beat Texas Tech the next week 50-44. Lost to TCU 22-29. Beat Baylor 42-3. And they also beat Miami in their bowl game 37-34. So they had a great finish off to the season. But overall, for Oklahoma State, this is a team that had a ton of potential going into 2020. And they overall played pretty well over the course of the season, having an 8-3 record. First five games, they were 4-1. Last six games, they were 4-2. Looking at your roster preview going into next season, you return your starting quarterback, Spencer Sanders. He's coming back for the 2021 season, which if you look at him over the course of last season, put up just over 2,000 yards, 14 touchdowns, 8 interceptions, and a 63% completion rate. So he really did not have a terrible season for the Cowboys. So watch out for him going into the 2021 season especially. I mean, for Spencer Sanders, he's a quarterback that I think has got plenty of potential. I mean, if you look at him even in 2019, he showed some pretty good potential, but he didn't improve a whole lot from 2019 to 2020. Of course, he had the exact same completion rate in 2019 as 2020, which is pretty rare, as he had a 62.8 completion rate in 2019 as well as in 2020, so which of course is pretty rare. But if you look at him going into 2021, I mean, he's losing a couple of weapons here, but he certainly has got some potential, I think, moving forward. Chuba Hubbard will not be with this team next season. He put up just right around 700 yards and 6 touchdowns last year. However, Desmond Jackson is coming back to the team next season, so expect him to have quite a big workload going into next season. He put up just over 560 yards and 4 touchdowns. As for the third running back, L.D. Brown, also watch out for him. This running back core is going to be pretty stacked with both of them. L.D. Brown last season put up just right around 500 yards and 2 touchdowns. As for the receiving core, you do lose your top wide receiver there in Tylan Wallace. Dylan Stoner is also not going to be with this team next season, so you got to watch out for both of them there. But Tylan Wallace put up just right around 930 yards, 6 touchdowns last season. And then Dylan Stoner, of course, looking at him, he put up just right around 600 yards and 4 touchdowns. So, of course, both of them are going to be pretty tough losses there, especially at first. But Braden Johnson is coming back. He's more than likely going to be the top wide receiver for this team next season. He put up just over 250 yards and a touchdown last year. So he'll be definitely a player to watch out for there. They lose two offensive linemen, one defensive lineman, and one linebacker, and then one in the secondary. So this team defensively is looking pretty good, I'd say. They're losing three starters overall, which is pretty much an average number. Most teams lose, I'd say, 3 to 4 in the offseason. So for Oklahoma State, that's pretty normal. But otherwise, offensively, this team does lose a couple of major skill players, especially in the receiving core. So you got to watch out for that. But overall, I'd say Oklahoma State looks pretty good in the returning production. This team definitely, I think, has got potential going into next year. Even though I think in 2020, like this team, especially last season, like it was easily told by the beginning parts of the season for this team. I mean, this team was potentially a contender last season, but they just had a couple of bad losses down the stretch, which really ruined their chances of that. But still, this team, I think, has got some potential to go pretty high in the Big 12. I think this team is going to be a contender next season, definitely a top half team in the conference next year. But looking at your schedule going into next season, you start off the year with Missouri State on September 4th. You got Tulsa after that, Boise State on the road on September 18th. So that'll be an interesting game between Boise State and Oklahoma State. You got Kansas State. It's your first conference game there on September 25th. You got Baylor then on the 2nd. You got Texas after your bye week on the road. You got Texas and Iowa State in back-to-back road games. Then you got Kansas, West Virginia, TCU, Texas Tech, and Oklahoma to finish out the season. So Oklahoma, that's going to be a a pretty brutal game there. Of course, you have to play both Iowa State and Oklahoma, which both Iowa State and Oklahoma next season are certainly going to be outstanding teams. Both of them will be national contenders next season. And so, of course, you got to play the Cyclones in Ames, too. Watch out for that. But for Oklahoma State, it's for the first half of the season. I think Missouri State's going to be a win. Tulsa's going to be a win. So you got two guaranteed wins to start off your season. Boise State should be a win. I'm definitely favoring the Cowboys right now, but with it being on the road, and Boise State is usually a place that's somewhat tough to play in, I think that could come to be a bit of a close matchup there, but I think Oklahoma State does get the win right now. But I'm not saying it's greater than an 80% chance of them winning it. Kansas State will be close. I probably would favor the Cowboys in that matchup as well, just because of how much Kansas State is losing. Baylor's going to be a win. Texas is going to be close as well. I think Texas next season definitely will be an interesting team. It's tough to predict Texas going into next year. I think both teams are pretty big question marks there. But as for the second half of the season, Iowa State, that's going to be an interesting matchup. It's going to be close. I probably favor Iowa State right now. But then Kansas, of course, that's going to be an easy win. You got four guaranteed wins on your schedule as of now with Missouri State, Tulsa, Baylor, and Kansas. West Virginia is going to be close. TCU is going to be close. I think TCU next season could definitely be a team to watch out for. Like, usually the Big 12 has got one or two teams that are pretty big surprises. Like, in 2019, that was Baylor. Baylor was the big surprise team in the Big 12 back then. Last year, of course, we saw Iowa State be a really good team. This year, it could be TCU. I think TCU should be back, and possibly, I mean, I like Max Duggan. And I mean, he, at the start of his career, he wasn't very good, but his improvement has really convinced me. I think TCU could be a contender next season. Not a national contender, but a Big 12 contender, at least. But for Oklahoma State here, otherwise, looking at the last four games, your November is definitely going to be the toughest month, I think, on your schedule, having to play TCU and then, of course, Oklahoma. Good thing is both TCU and Oklahoma are home games, but then again, you got to play Texas and Iowa State on the road in October, so that's also a tough stretch in through there. But Texas Tech, I'd probably favor Oklahoma State there as well, but I'm going to keep it as a yellow game for now. And, of course, Oklahoma to finish out the season. Oklahoma is my current favorite to win the Big 12. It wouldn't surprise me to see them win yet another Big 12 championship, but Oklahoma next season especially, that Oklahoma team is looking great. I think the Sooners are going to be a national contender for sure, like top four. I can see that team in the national championship game next season with Spencer Rattler on the rise in Oklahoma, and in general, that team has got some great returning production. They're going to be a tough team to beat next season, and I'm not going to put it as a guaranteed loss right now, but I'm definitely favoring the Sooners in that matchup. But as for the Oklahoma State here, your ceiling's going to be 10-2. So that's the best I think you possibly could be next season, which that seems kind of low for some of you fans. But I think for Oklahoma State next season, that would be a pretty high record for this team, considering the skill players that they're losing in general. But projection will be 8-4 for you next year. That would be an excellent record, I think, to hit for Oklahoma State, especially considering the tough schedule. 6-6 will be the floor. So I've got you going to a bowl game no matter what next season, no matter whether it's a bad season or a good season. You will be going to a bowl game no matter what. I just can't imagine this team missing a bowl game, especially after their great 2020 season. But 8-4 will be the projection for Oklahoma State next season. I'm predicting a pretty good year for Oklahoma State. Let me know your thoughts in the comments below on the Cowboys. Let me know your record predictions and all of that down in the comments. I appreciate you guys all watching, though. Stay tuned for more from All Sports Central. I'll see you guys all later.